Hello, it's Rachel Lawson here again from the Drupal Association. And today I'm catching up again with the leads from the Easy Out of the Box initiative. We've got Tim, we've got Amy June, Emily, Christina, Jessica, and Sasha with us today. We've got a really big group. Thank you for all coming along and telling us all about the experiences you had at DrupalCon and what's happening now. I noticed yet again, it's fabulous weather in Barcelona, Christina. Once again, always seems to be the way. So I should start off and ask, you know, DrupalCon was an incredibly intense time for us all. How have you been trying to unwind and relax since DrupalCon, anybody?
I took a couple days off just to not do anything. You know, but I swung back into the swing of things almost immediately after that because, you know, it's Drupal.
Yeah, that's true.
I've been painting my daughter's room, so that's been fun.
Ah, cool. Yeah. Okay. Well, I tell you what, we'll move on. In the weeks before DrupalCon, we spoke and the Easy Out of the Box initiative then was still quite young and still forming as a thing. So we were bringing you all together in some ways and solidifying what the Easy Out of the Box initiative was. So can you tell me what effect did having to organize yourselves to be ready for running a keynote at DrupalCon and all the contribution stuff and so on, what effect did that have on how you were organizing the Easy Out of the Box initiative itself?
I can say that the largest contribution was that we have Amy June helping now. Roped her in as a mentor lead, and she's now been helping kind of organize the weekly day-to-day workings of the initiative. We're still kind of leaderless in a way. Each part of the initiative is kind of speaking for themselves a bit. But I think it's been a good division of labor so far. And now we have Jessica, who's been helping out in a big way since DrupalCon.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah, I mean, it's funny you should mention that. Our goal at the Drupal Association with this format was to help grow the community contributing specifically to the strategic objectives. And I see we have a new face with us today. Welcome, Jessica. Maybe you'd like to tell us a little bit about who you are and what made you join all of these people and get involved in Easy Out of the Box.
Hi. So I am a student here. I'm from Brazil originally. And yeah. So Emily is my friend, and she told me about the Easy Out of the Box initiative because she knew that I am studying to be a project manager. And I really want to be a project manager at Drupal. So like she thought that will be a good idea to get involved and, you know, develop my skills while helping the Easy Out of the Box. And it's been a little bit less than a month since I started, and I already learned so many things and I met so many people, and it's really good.
Oh, fantastic. It's great because doing something like this, you get to meet all these incredible people across, you know, really cutting edge things within open source and Drupal. It's a privilege in many ways to be able to do that. And I'm sure we're all really happy that you're here and helping and demonstrating the skills you already have. So thank you very much. Yeah, so you've come along, you've started to get involved on a long-term basis and opening this up to the whole group, helping people to make contribution a habit, something that they're doing on a regular basis, is important to us all and especially important to the future of Drupal itself. What things are the Easy Out of the Box team doing to help people get into that habit? I think, Jessica, you were saying that you're helping run the regular meetings, is that right? So people can come along to those regular meetings. Where do they take place?
They're on Slack every Monday. And currently I am helping to run the meetings with Amy June. And also I am trying to contribute in the marketing meta issue. So we are trying to work on that.
I want to elaborate on what Jessica was talking about. Another way that we're promoting and trying to get people involved is we created some marketing tasks for folks. So if people are marketing and don't have a lot of code experience, they can definitely help us with marketing. But the idea around the marketing is to create a logo, some social media, and a slide deck that we can take to contribution camps so we can help promote at a camp the sprint, you know, that usually concludes with the camp. So, you know, because we still want some new folks contributing, or some, you know, because of the nature of the initiative, we need experienced folks to be excited and to help us like move some of these more advanced issues over the line. So really promoting it at contribution days is going to be important for us through the summer.
And by the way, the Slack channel is easy out of the box if you're trying to find it.
Oh, that's brilliant. I was just about to ask that, so that's good.
And the meetings on Monday are at 9 a.m. Pacific, noon Eastern time, and 4 p.m. UTC.
Wonderful. Yeah. So we should be able to find those. So that would that be the thing that you would want people to do when they finish this video? Go join that Slack channel? Is that the thing? Is anything else you would like people to do straight after they've watched this video? Anything in particular?
I think coming to the Slack channel would be the number one thing to do, the first step. In the issue queues also, at least in the core issue queue, there are issues tagged easy out of the box with spaces, not hyphens. And so you can find issues that we've been working on or that we want to work on through there. But coming to the Slack channel would be the first step.
Brilliant.
And we do reserve a space in the weekly meetings for people to introduce themselves. And that way, I think there's also a thread where we ask how we can help people get involved, where I've had some people say, oh, I'm a front end, and then I point them in more of a direction. So we have a lot of people who come to the meetings, but we'd like those people to be more actively involved and participate a little bit more too, and just sort of ask us where we think their skill set can go, and we can help align people with their passion and skill set too in those weekly meetings.
Oh, wonderful. And you've got lots of jobs for skills at all levels by the sound of it, and different types of work as well, different types of issues. You were mentioning marketing earlier on. You were met that obviously I'm sure there's a little bit of code involved somewhere. And oh, wonderful. That's fantastic.
And there's also even issues where we just need people to come in and offer their opinions and discuss how they would like to use certain things.
Mm. Because you're wanting to make it easier for people. So you need actual people to say, this is easier than that. Yeah, I like it. Yeah, cool. Okay, so I'm going to move on from what happened there. Let's think about maybe if we did something like this again, if we had a DrupalCon where we had specific initiative days at some point in the future, or even another conference name or something like that, maybe another virtual thing. We had the same sort of format again. Would there be any particular initiatives, either existing ones or ones yet to be formed, that you think should be included for a day?
I think Dries unveiled his idea for a project browser. And I think that actually dovetails really well with Easy Out of the Box. I mean, we want people to be able to, you know, use Drupal right away and get a lot of things done. But even no matter how many features we have in core, there's thousands more in contrib. And making it easy for people to find those and test them out and try them out on their site with just through the UI is very important. So that is an initiative that doesn't exist yet, but has a lot of enthusiasm and momentum building.
Yeah.
I'd also like to see an initiative where it's not code-centric, like maybe even bringing back the documentation initiative. That way those people that we are always inviting to come, the non-coders, have a really safe place to go, because I still feel people are reluctant to jump into these more advanced, you know, bug smash, you know, as a non-coder. So if we bring back something where people can like ease into the issue queue a little bit more, like maybe on a Monday or Tuesday, then the rest of the week they feel more empowered to like help with documentation in the media initiative, or you know, move forward some UI interface documentation, that kind of thing. So that would be really neat to help us bring in everyone, you know, in a more safe feeling place for not novices, but new contributors in general.
Wonderful. Any further ideas?
So I think kind of on that note, there's also sort of a promote Drupal initiative going on to get marketing going. So I think that would be another one that would be really good.
I think that idea about getting people that is not just coders in there, I guess Sasha would agree, creating the design system on a separate place will be something really useful for Claro and the new administration UI. And it will be great to get in place an initiative or something like that that takes care of creating this new Drupal design system or Drupal administration design system or whatever is the name that we come up with, and create that so it can be used and expanded.
Oh yeah, I like it. And I'm thinking now, having Jessica here, it's just got me thinking, maybe we could also have initiatives that are not about necessarily what we're producing, but the people who are helping produce it. So maybe we could have a students initiative where we look and find out what are the really best ways to help students like Jessica come into the things that are already taking place. Maybe that would be an interesting kind of thing to play with.
Yeah. And then also an idea me and my team kicked around was when we have those idea-based issues, some people feel they're not qualified to be part of the conversation. So maybe having BOFs where we invite community participation allows people easier access to come in and feel like they can actually say something about those, you know, more abstract ideas about the roadmaps and the designs and things like that.
Yeah. Oh, wonderful. Cool. Well, thank you for a lot of really great ideas. Thanks for telling us about what you're up to and a little bit of a recap of things that happened at DrupalCon. Really good to see you on the team, Jessica. I'm sure that lots of people will be wanting to join you and get involved, which would be great. And they will find you in the Easy Out of the Box Slack channel. And you have meetings on Monday, you say. Wonderful. Well, in that case, thank you very much. And I will see you again, probably in the Slack channel. Thank you. Bye.